your papers are due on the topic of God's wrath. Don't forget to include in there sinners burning in everlasting hell. And for extra credit, include drawings of demons and pitchforks and such.
Yes, Friar Ned.
Excellent. Next class in 5 minutes with Friar Ned.
Alana, have you worked on that paper yet?
Yes, Amelia. I read all the books Friar Ned recommended. No wonder people paid so much money to the church or even join the monastery just to avoid going to hell when they die.
But have you read what God really thinks of us? About his love and his mercy?
Why would I read the Bible? The friars and the church leaders tell us what it says. They should know.
Here, read what God actually thinks about you.
As you are precious in my sight, is this Bible verses in Italian, not Latin? You can't.
Good morning, class.
Uh-oh. Friar, that's a little early. Oh boy. And if he catches Amelia sharing the Bible here with this girl, it's going to cause problems for the plan for Amelia to meet up with Lucian later in the monastery. Oh! I get official permission to distract the professor!
That worked out.
That's so great. Yeah, Amelia can
I mean, it's got the potential for good.
Wait.
I'm just saying, I mean, do you remember where we are right now? We're in a flashback. Remember that? We're in Huss's flashback. He's telling Jerome the story of the Waldensians because he wants to teach Jerome that when you stand for God, yes, sometimes you are saved and protected by God from danger and death and suffering, like Wycliffe, but other times, God's people suffer and die.
So, do you think that maybe the story doesn't have a happy ending?
That's quite possible. I mean, this world is not a friend to God and his people. And speaking of which, here come some enemies.
So this is where Lucian, my missing monk, has been hiding for 3 days?
Maybe. It's Aemilia's home, and she's definitely a troublemaker. Look, she gave me these Bible verses. In Italian. And did you notice her last name?
Aemilia Waldo, so?
Who's Waldo?
Where's Waldo?
Hello, Peter Waldo. The leader of the Waldenses.
I wonder where they got their name from.
Wait, can we like protect them? Like help them not be able to see where the door is?
You know, I'd like to do that. I think that would be great, but we're getting official command not to intervene right now.
Open up in the name of Pope Lucius III.
Yeah! Come on out, Lucius! We know you're in there!
No, Friar Ed. Lucius is the Pope. Our monk is Lucian.
Well, one of you is in there! Come on out!
Hello, Friar Ned. Friar Ed, thanks for looking for me. I'm not coming back.
Oh!
Friar Ed, heal! Lucian, God is already angry with you for running away and socializing with the Sabbath-keeping Waldensian. Don't make God angrier by refusing my commands!
Tell him what the Bible says, Lucian.
That's for the Lord. Okay, enough, where have you been? I've promised you by your tongue. When I pass through the waters, I will be with you. When you pass through the fire, you will not be born. For I am the one you saw, since I have the power to carry my tongue. For I have been over my mind.
Wow. What's that?
Heresy! This woman has been sharing the Bible with the people!
Oh, Aemilia, we're praying for you.
Aemilia Waldo, you're now under arrest.
Stand firm in Jesus, Aemilia.
Will I take him too?
I'll give you one more chance, Lucian. Recant this Waldensian woman and her heresy, and...
Okay.
You won't be singing this tune when you are both sent to the stake. And you'll be burning in hell forever!
Alar, I forgive you. You don't understand. But read the Bible and you will!
So God walked through the fire to protect the people's lives?
Maybe. Is that what it's all about?
Is what all about?
Well, you saw Laura. She was so interested in the verses that they were reading. And you saw Friar Ed when Lucian was talking about the scripture. He was genuinely involved in it. And maybe that's why they're having to go, Aemilia and Lucian are having to go through such a bitter test.
I think that must be part of it. Do you remember previous years, we've talked about the ripples that we've seen, the ripples in the stories, how the Holy Spirit can take that faith and courage when one person stands for God, and then he uses that faith and courage to impact someone else to stand for God, and they impact more people to stand for God, and it becomes like ripples spreading out after a stone has been dropped in the water.
I remember that.
Yes. The events from this flashback can have ripples throughout eternity. And definitely into the future with Huss and Jerome.
I believe that. I believe that this flashback will have ripples. But it must be so hard for humans to have faith that God can take the things that are so painful in their suffering and turn it to something good.
Look, I totally agree. Aemilia and Lucian, they're scared. They've been given a death sentence. Oh, but good news. We've been given instruction that we can encourage them.
Oh, yes.
By showing them the rest of the fiery furnace story in their dreams.
Yes, wait, let's do it.
Walking on holy ground, and I will walk with you.
But will we die?
And will it hurt?
You will sleep, but you will not feel the pain. And the next thing you'll know, I will be raising you up along with others who will join the chain of truth because of your faithful example.
Part of the chain of truth, like Jesus just said. And if he's part of the chain of truth, then either one of two things will happen. Either God will step in and will rescue him, just like he did in the fiery furnace, or he will give him the courage to stand, just like he did for these Waldenses.
Yes. Oh, let's go to Gottlieb's dungeon. I want to make sure that Jerome understands.
Yes,
how.
Jerome needs to know.
Yeah.